Hi. So to shoot this video, I kind of posted a question on a couple of the forums of what did you guys want to know about this knife? Because I tried to film this earlier and just couldn't come up with a darn thing. So got a bunch of questions here and a bunch of answers for you guys. First one, several of you asked what made me choose this kind of knife to make? This kind of dagger or variations of that question. Well, I wanted to make a classic medieval dagger, what you'd call like a knight's dagger, with a more modern twist. It's no way based on anything historic or anything like that. It's kind of all from my own head. But the reason I wanted to make a dagger was daggers are like swords, and they're kind of what Peter Johnson calls objects of power. They invoke certain things in our minds, and they portray certain feelings when you look at them. For me, a dagger is a symbol of power and strength and truth and justice and all the fun stuff that comes along with chivalry. And of late, I've kind of needed that, so I wanted to build something that expressed that to the world, kind of impart that back to the world. It's about the only thing I do that's very artistic is try to base what I'm doing on an idea instead of just on a style or use. Yeah. Anyway, there's another thing on this knife that's a little bit secretive, and that comes in the materials choice. Several of you asked what I used for materials and how I chose them. Well, the steel on this is all from the same bar of Damascus. It's all crushed W's, which is something I've been playing a lot more with lately. And I like the idea of showing pattern development. So this knife, when you start at the pommel and work your way down to the blade, each piece is the same bar that has been manipulated in a new fashion. The pommel is just as I forge the bar. The bars that make the fittings are that same bar, just compressed. The bar that makes the guard is that bar compressed, upset, and drawn and shaped into the guard. And the blade itself is that same bar drawn out and what I call a serpentine ladder, which is laddering from either side so that you have this nice S serpent down the middle of the blade. I chose to use 15N20 and 1080 15N20 and 1080 for the steels because 1080 gives a nice contrast with a fairly high manganese content. And the heat treat very similarly. They're a reliable performance, reliable heat treat, and they just work really well together and give nice contrast. It's kind of one of my favorite mixes right now. Dan Cassidy asked me how I did the welding for this knife. Well, all the welding was done atmospheric, no flux or oil or anything. It was all just stacked up. I TIG welded the corners, put it in the forge, soaked it at high temperatures, and then threw it under the 4B nozzle hammer, welded it up. The initial stack was 21 layers. I then drew that for crushed W's to 6 layers. That was welded, crushed again, and then restacked at 5, which was then forged into a round bar. And that's what gives that pattern there. So why did I choose the rest of the materials? Oh, this piece of quilted maple here is just something I had, we had stabilized last year. And I just really felt like that quilting matched well with the pattern of the blade. So when I went through the handle materials, that was the one I chose. I've kind of been saving it for something special. The carnelians that I used on the pommel and on the pommel nut actually came from when I was on Forge and Fire. I purchased those to use on the katana. They were extras. So it's kind of a nice touch to use something from a previous special blade for another special blade. Dave Stevens asked me why I used pattern welding for the Garden Ferrules. To me, the JS Knife of the Year is something that's supposed to express our skill as bladesmiths. And a big reason that we are bladesmiths is to make pattern weld material. But beyond that, in the skill it takes to make the pattern weld itself, I really love pattern welding because it tends to show every hammer blow in its form. your skill at forging can be seen in the blade itself if you know what to look for. And I like that. I like that a lot. So I felt like this absolutely positively had to be Damascus no matter what I was going to make. Colin Miller asked me, what tools or techniques do you use differently to make the dagger symmetrical? Well, I said, you know, it's a struggle for me to get things symmetrical anyway. Symmetry is something I always struggle with. I did a number of things to try to keep this symmetrical. I spent much of the time making this knife with a scribed center line down the middle of it and measured everything off that known surface. That was helpful. I had a piece of graph paper on my bench, and every once in a while I would trace the knife, flip it over, and trace it again. And if the two things were off, then I knew there was something deviating, and I had to correct that. But quite honestly, in the end, it was really just looking at it really hard and trying to find out where that doesn't look right and trying to straighten that out. And it is pretty symmetrical at this point. I'm pretty happy with it. You can spin it by the pommel and it stays, you know, reasonably centered. Ooh, drop it on top of people. That was another trick I did. I actually chucked the threads for the pommel up in the drill press and spun it, see if there was a deviation or a wobble, and there wasn't. But trying to keep everything symmetrical the whole time and not letting anything deviate seemed to be the best course of action. So Robert Burns asked about the stone settings. As you can see, Robert, they are on both sides. They're set in sterling silver bezels, which I buy as pre-made cups. These two are just pressed in and double set with G-Flex epoxy to be sure they stay in place. This one was a little more challenging to set because I couldn't just press it in because there was a thread, so I couldn't do it ahead of time. After the knife was fully assembled and glued up, I dropped some epoxy in the hole, I pressed this in, and then I came around the outside of the bezel with a punch and upset the bezel into the steel, evening it up and also polishing it, but with a hammer polishing it, and really binding that down in there. It's never going to come apart, and if this knife ever needs to be taken apart, really don't know how I'm going to do it. It should never come apart. Let's put it that way. All right. Connor J. What is the average airspeed of a lace of airspeed velocity of a laden swallow? African or European? You gotta do that in the helmet, I think. African or European? My name is Matthew Parkinson, Journeyman Smith in the ABS. I was asked to do the Journeyman Smith knife of the year, and here it is.